Babies can be downright adorable. I mean, look at this guy. But regardless of cuteness and regardless of species, it is babies that carry on the legacy of their kind. This baby here is unlike any other, and it owes its unique DNA to a process called meiosis. In today's lesson, we'll be exploring this process as we explain the similarities and differences between meiosis and mitosis, evaluate how meiosis contributes to the diversity of life, and describe some of the effects mutations can have on living things. Let's get into it! As you might recall from a previous lesson, mitosis is the phase of the cell cycle where a cell actively divides into two identical cells. The key word here is identical. When making more of our own cells, we want them all to have the same DNA so they can all work together efficiently. However, we know that children are not exact copies of their parents. So mitosis can't be responsible for transferring genetic information across generations. This is where meiosis comes in. Meiosis is the process of creating specialized cells for the purpose of reproduction. There are two key differences between mitosis and meiosis that we'll be focusing on. The first is a phenomenon called crossing over. Crossing over is when two paired chromosomes exchange genetic information. In practice, it looks almost like they're giving each other a hug or a high five. This creates unique individual chromosomes that are different from parent chromosomes, allowing for more diverse outcomes in offspring. The second major difference is the number of times that the DNA divides. Both mitosis and meiosis synthesize, or create an extra copy, of the cell's DNA. However, while in mitosis, the DNA divides once to create two cells with full sets of chromosomes. In meiosis, the DNA divides twice. This results in four haploid cells, which are cells with only one set of chromosomes instead of two. You can think of this as haploid, meaning half the normal number of chromosomes. In males, this process creates sperm cells, and in females, it creates egg cells. When these haploid cells are combined together, the result is a cell with a complete set of chromosomes. This one cell contains the blueprint, or genetic instructions, for a whole new life form that is entirely unique from its parents. Meiosis is a huge driving force in the diversity of life on Earth. It's the reason that humans have so many unique traits, just like dogs, cats, and countless other species do. However, like mitosis, this process is not perfect and can result in errors when copying DNA. An error that occurs when DNA is copied is called a mutation. With cancer as an exception, mutations that occur during mitosis typically have little effect because the mutation only changes one cell out of trillions. However, mutations in haploid cells typically have a much larger impact. Remember, when haploid cells combine, they form the blueprint for an entire new organism. All other cells are created from the division of this original cell, so any errors in the code are literally translated into every cell of the body. Errors that affect the way proteins are made can have a variety of effects. For example, a condition called albinism is the result of a mutation that affects proteins responsible for pigment, or color. Without these pigments, this wallaby's fur is white instead of its usual brown color. Another example is sickle cell anemia. This condition is caused by a mutation that affects the structure of red blood cells, which makes them less effective at delivering oxygen in the body. Additionally, non-disjunction can occur, which is when chromosomes fail to separate properly during meiosis. When this occurs, the result is an abnormal amount of chromosomes when haploid cells combine. This can be diagnosed using a karyotype, which is a map of the number and appearance of all of the different chromosomes in an organism. For example, Down syndrome is the result of an extra chromosome in the 21st pairing, while Turner's syndrome is the result of a missing X chromosome in the 23rd pairing. Some mutations cause disease, such as sickle cell anemia. Others cause changes that are not typical, such as Down syndrome. And some mutations are capable of producing new traits that benefit entire species, such as stronger jaw muscles in a shark. In this way, meiosis creates diversity in a variety of ways that are not always expected. All right, we have now covered the basics of meiosis. We've learned that meiosis is similar to mitosis with two key differences. The first difference is crossing over, which is when paired chromosomes exchange genetic information to create unique genetic outcomes. The second difference is that while mitosis divides a cell's DNA once, meiosis divides DNA twice to create four haploid cells, which each have half the normal number of chromosomes. When haploid cells combine, they create a complete set of chromosomes. Like mitosis, meiosis is imperfect and can sometimes result in mutations or errors in DNA. A mutation in meiosis affects all of the cells of potential offspring. This can result in a variety of conditions in the offspring that range from harmful to beneficial. And with that, we have concluded our unit covering DNA and genetics. In our next unit, we'll be taking a look at how traits compete with each other to influence the diversity of life here on Earth. Until then, I'm Caroline, and remember, life is full of wonders. So keep learning and don't ever stop wondering. Hey, hey.